What up, y'all? It's your girl, Chelsea Nicole. And I'm in my feelings this evening, so it's time for an episode of Facts Only. It's only right. It's only right. So, you know, I've been on a little hiatus lately because I could do that. I do what I want when I feel like it. That's just how my personality is set up. So those who know me, love me, and know that it ain't no shade. It's just Chelsea's gonna do what Chelsea wants to do. So if I want to do my show, I'm doing my show. And if I don't want to do my show, then I'm not doing my show. You can ask me whether or not I'm doing my show or why I'm not doing my show, because I can have these conversations. I'm talkative. Y'all know me. That's what this whole show is about. Me talking, right? So, you know, if you was looking for me, here I am. The fuck? It's not that deep. So, I really wanted to talk about some shit. Like I said, I'm in my feelings, so here I am. I want to talk about some shit. I got some stuff to get off my chest real quick. So, I was sent an article today, something in CBS News about, actually, I need to be putting on my coconut oil. I just got out the shower, so my skin be dry, so I'm gonna do this at the same time. So, I read this article that this 5-year-old girl in Texas was getting bullied on the bus by older kids. All right. Okay. Fight me then. You acting tough. I was looking for you. You wasn't looking for me. You wasn't. Don't act like that. Don't try to embarrass me in front of company. Don't you dare. Don't you try it. Nah, but in Texas, little girl on the bus, and you know, they on the small bus or whatever. Don't really make a difference whether the bus is long or short or whatever the case may be. But little 5-year-old girl is on the bus and she's getting bullied by some older kids. These kids, I don't know how old they were. I don't know what the age differences were, because of course the kids is blurred out or whatever the case, because now your parents is embarrassed, but wasn't embarrassed sending your old raggedy asses out on people buses beating up other kids. Let me tell y'all the whole story first. All right, so this little 5-year-old girl is on the bus and she's literally like getting beat up. They punching her, they hitting her, they choking her, they stabbing her with a pencil. Of course, the bus has the camera, so this video goes on for like 12 minutes tops. The bus driver, the only thing that the bus driver says is, leave her alone. You hear this girl, she's like, oh, this person is out of their seat. They're hitting me. Can somebody help me? Bus driver, bus driver. The little girl's calling out for the bus driver. 5 years old. Little girl calling out for the bus driver. Bus driver don't do shit. Don't pull over the bus. Don't call the school. Don't call whatever station, headquarters, whatever the fuck. Don't call nobody, just leave her alone. And keeps riding the bus. And this little girl's getting stabbed with pencils and all this other shit. All right, so if that don't piss you off already, the little girl tells her mother, she goes to the school or the board of education or whoever the fuck she go to, is the wrong people she went to. These motherfuckers charged her $600 to get a copy of the video. They charged this woman $600 to get a copy of her child being beat up on this bus. Yeah, I would have flipped if that was my baby. That's some unheard of shit. That don't make no sense. I sent my child to this public ass school on this yellow ass fucking school bus that all these taxpayers been paying for. I'm telling y'all, I'm mad. I'm so mad. And I don't even have kids. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's so many things that are happening to our children right now. Bro. She gonna get it back when she sue the district. That's what I'm saying. I'm like, bro. She need a more than suit. Bro, if she's suing, I want to sue too. I need to sue some people. We need to sue some people. I'm telling you, because If it's 800 or 80 mil or whatever the mils is for Donald Trump's head, y'all getting this money from somewhere. So why y'all out here giving out money to get the fool man we're gonna put in the place in the first place to come out? If that's the type of money that y'all just out here throwing around just to kill Donald Trump, then I need my coins. Y'all fucking with the wrong one. Y'all fucking with the wrong one. I'm about to sue you. Sue me for what? I mean, you could try. You're not gonna win. I watch Judge Judy for a living. Like, that's my part-time job. Okay. You're not gonna win. Anywho, but nah, that shit is crazy. Like, how do we send our kids out to school expecting that our kids are learning, hopefully, in the hands of these fucking people who let your child get beat up on a school bus? The hell? Hey, sexy girl. I felt some air energy pop up on the screen, you know, fellow Geminis. Shout out to all my Geminis out there. I'm going to start talking fast, so I'm going to start stuttering and bucking over my words. But I'm a real nigga, so I'm going to breeze and bounce right through that shit. Don't worry. It'll be all right. But no, seriously, the type of shit that they're doing to these kids is fucking crazy. So I have a friend. Love her to death. I should be doing my hair, too. My leave-in conditioner is in the bag in the corner. I like to keep my stuff together so I know where it is later. My mama taught me that. But the fucking minor age limit, the child labor laws is all changed now. Connecticut. I hope a lot of Connecticut watchers are, you know y'all be lurking. Connecticut, home of the scammers. Y'all out here peeping and shit. So did y'all peep that the child labor laws in Connecticut, before when we were in high school, like if you had a job, you had to be out at like 9 o'clock on a weekday, I want to say, like you couldn't work past 9 o'clock, and then on the weekends maybe you could stay later, 9:30, 10 o'clock maybe, if that, right? Why these kids could be out working places till midnight? High school kids, 16, 17 years old, out working till midnight. Got school, out working somewhere at midnight. And this particular friend of mine, like her sister, is at a Subway, which is cool. Subway is a cool first job. Shout outs to all my Subway sandwich artists. Shout outs to y'all. Like, that's a cool first job. It's not McDonald's. Y'all was helping niggas eat fresh before. I'm just saying. So she works at a Subway, but the Subway is in a gas station. Gas stations get robbed, they get shot up, they get, you know what I'm saying, like weird ass people walk in and out of gas stations on a daily basis. So for a minor who is in school, who has to be working to make sure that, you know, she has the money in her pocket, or she help out with the household, or whatever the case may be, like for whatever reason that the minor needs to be working, they could work till midnight in a gas station and the manager don't be coming there to check on her or to close the store or to do none of that stuff. She doing it? So is she the manager? Because are y'all gonna pay this minor girl who does not have a diploma yet? You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all do, like, they're out here doing shicey shit to the picnic them. They're starting from early and they don't care, because who else does? Who cares? Girl, till midnight. Minors working until midnight. Got school in the morning. Don't got their own car. Not driving. Somebody else got to come pick them up. You know what I'm saying? Like, minor kids who should be worried about other things. You got to start working from... And then they want to rape... Girl, I be really tight. Like, the type of shit that be happening in this country, on this planet, I had to explain to my little dude that fucking Australia burning up and all the baby koalas and all the kangaroos broke his heart. Broke his heart. He was so sad for the animals. So sad for the animals. My baby was so sad for the damn animals. Like, he's like, bruh, it looks like it's a war between the humans and the animals. I was like, baby, it looked like it. And he's like, well, I hope the animals win. I'm like, baby, I hope they do too. Because, bruh, this ain't right. They're not even supposed to work past 9. This world is disgusting. No, for real. That's crazy. Kids are not supposed to be working past 9. When we were, for me to be saying, like, when I was young, when we were younger, back in the day, like, it wasn't even that long ago. It really wasn't even that long ago. So for us to have to say, like, oh, back in the day, or it wasn't just, like, for things to have changed and took such an abrupt change at that, for nobody to even warn nobody, you know what I'm saying? Like, y'all doing the little things here and there, and y'all raising taxes, and y'all doing whatever it is that y'all doing. But as far as, like, what y'all doing for your communities, your country, the people that you love and care for. We supposed to be so proud to be American, right? What is there to be proud of? Tell me. Start from the top. We the people, that's where you're going to take it from? That's where you're going to take it from? Because in this country that we live in, a kid could go to a public school where they say a national anthem and Pledge of Allegiance and all them things there. You're sending your child to a whole public school where they're supposed to feel safe. These adults are supposed to be watching them. You're telling me that I'm going to birth a child, put them in your care? You going to teach my baby some shit? Oh, okay. You're gonna teach my child something? Got me fucked up. Cause y'all never wanted niggas to read, first and foremost, cause you thought I ain't know. You thought niggas ain't know. Y'all didn't want niggas to be reading in the first place. Now we're all caught up. And history been repeating itself since history been repeating. And you expected what? Nobody was going to say shit or... Nah, like, I'm mad. I don't know about y'all, but, like, this is upsetting. This is upsetting. That's upsetting. That's upsetting. It has a lot to do with the parents as well, though, making their children feel like, oh, 18, you out, or 18, you got to go. Shaking my head. We need to break that cycle because it's not okay. Show ain't. Because back in the day, in they a day, or whoever a day, 18, you was an adult. You had to figure it out. You had to figure it out. No. Motherfuckers clearly don't even start wanting to figure shit out until a nigga hit the dirty 30. Get the fuck out of here. I'm not hearing that. Y'all think because a motherfucker turned 18, he could do this on his own. Oh, he could buy a pack of cigarettes. Y'all think because the motherfucker decided he wanted to put some shit to his mouth and puff? A crackhead had to start somewhere. The fuck is you talking about? Like, what are y'all even? Come the fuck on. Like, is nobody else outraged? Like, and then for you to take your outrage, can we do something about that? Like, who do we talk to? Because talking amongst ourselves is not really getting anywhere at this point. And they're still putting on more shit that doesn't make sense, putting that shit on the news. It's stuff that we absorb every day. Social media, scrolling through all the dumb shit that's happening. The kids, like, some article popped up and they're talking about Trump and that dude in Iran and all this stuff and the third. And I don't even know the full story about what's going on, because honestly, it's so sad and so disgusting. And I know they're not even all telling the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help them, God, because most of them don't even believe in God. Most of them already sold their soul. Most of them don't even know. Simmer, Chelsea. I'm telling you, like, all the fire that's actually in my birth chart, my natal chart, if you don't know yours, go figure it out. All the stuff in mine, it's a lot of fire. It's a lot of passion. So I don't care about nothing that's not worth caring about. I care for a lot of things. Most things, even. I care. I just don't give a fuck. So that's the balance that I have to deal with daily. Caring about some shit and not giving a fuck. So because I care so much about your child, the person next to you's child, you, your mama, your pops, and the future to come, because I give a fuck about that shit, I care about that shit. I care about that shit. I care. And I give a fuck. I can't give a fuck about how people feel when we have uncomfortable and taboo-ass conversations. I can't give a fuck about that. I can't give a fuck about your feelings, is basically what I'm saying. So that's why my show is called Facts Only, because I don't give a fuck about your feelings. I don't give a fuck about your feelings. I don't give a fuck about your opinions. I don't give a fuck about none of that shit at all. Let's talk about the facts of the matter. Let's get real black and white with it and then create the color. Let's do that first. Let's start, take it from the top. Let's be business casual. Let's talk business first and then talk that casual small talk bullshit after we done figured out the business part. Let's do that. Let's do that. Let's start there. Let's start there. Let's start with the facts. Let's take it from the top. Let's take it from the top. All that we the people stuff, all that in the beginning stuff, let's take it from the top. Let's write it all out. Let's write it all out. Let's take account. These motherfuckers need to take accountability. We need to know of all, every and every last melanated person who was killed, captured, kidnapped, murdered, tricked, bamboozled, and led astray. Every last one of them, write them motherfuckers the fuck out. Because y'all have to pay bread for this. Y'all have to pay bread for this. Like, y'all have to pay money for this. Like, that don't make no sense. That shit is not okay. And granted, I started this video talking about the little 5-year-old girl in Texas who was getting bullied on the bus. Her mother had to go to the school and pay $600 to get a videotape to watch kids beating on her kid when she already, you know, that's how the video started. But it's just like, there's so many other treacherous, dangerous ass things that's happening in this world, and they make you feel like you have no control and no say about it. They lie about everything. This land has been built on lie upon lie. Lie upon lie upon lie upon lie. And me, being the host of a show called Facts Only, how the fuck? How the fuck y'all think I feel? No, I'm distraught. Okay, my whole life feels like it's in shambles. No, I'm not gonna speak that into existence. But no, on some real shit. Like, I'm being funny, but that's not okay. That shit is not okay. That's not okay. That's not okay. And it's not gonna be okay until it's fucking okay. I said what the fuck I said. I'm really looking for one of my remotes because I really want to play Pandora. And another thing, like, I'm tired. All right, so know y'all rights. That was what I said first. So know y'all rights. I'm tired of Facebook and everybody thinking that you got to come on your Facebook and be on a live video or whatever, you recording a video or whatever, and you talking about some, I don't own the rights to this music that's playing in the background. Bitch, the fuck you do. The fuck you do. I'ma play my music in the background. I don't care. I own all the parts to that fucking music playing in the background because I bought the Fire Stick. I have the Pandora premium account that I pay for out this bitch. I paid for the Wi-Fi this month. The fuck? I own parts to the music that's playing in the background because I paid for that shit. to hear that shit. So if I'm gonna record that shit, if I'm gonna record me listening to that shit, I have the right to do that because I bought that shit. The fuck? I bought the shit and y'all telling me I gotta come on Facebook and tell Facebook I don't own that shit? Bitch, you got me fucked up. I told you I'm in my feelings tonight. So if, excuse me if you don't like cursing. Excuse me if you don't like cursing. Excuse me if you don't like cursing. Excuse me if I'm getting too loud. I'll step up from the mic. Excuse me. Excuse the fuck out of me. Because the last time I fucking checked. Last time Alexa play. And you know Alexa upstairs. You know Alexa upstairs. She always listening when she feel like it. Brought Alexa to a fucking event. They had Wi-Fi. Hooked up the Wi-Fi. Alexa don't want to work. She don't want to play. Go to the Alexa app on your device. And that, I did all of that. Alexa still ain't want to work. But she the Echo Dot, bitch. Dot, the dot, dot, dot. Love, dot, dot, dot. The fuck? No. Like, that shit is so dumb. Y'all have us out here paying for this, that, and the third, and all these amenities, and all this stuff that's supposed to improve your quality of fucking life. And y'all got us telling you, y'all got us telling Facebook that we don't own rights to music? Y'all keep telling Lauryn Hill she don't own rights to the miseducation of Lauryn Hill? She don't own the rights to that shit? As a Gemini, I wouldn't come perform for not another motherfucker in a blood clot life. What? Shout out to Lauryn Hill, another glorious Gemini, by the way. But no, like, it don't make no sense. It don't make no sense. It's not okay. It's not okay. It's not okay. And they need to stop acting like it's okay, because it's really not. It's really not. Bro, y'all got time? Y'all got time? Until my phone finna die, but go into a job every day to be surrounded by white people who tell you how much they don't have to be in there working. They telling you every day how much they don't have to be working. I don't have to do this. We have money. I came from money and grew up with money. And this one had this job. And that one had that job. And this one does my floors. And this one does my this. And this one does my that. And my daughter bought this. And never popped the tag. And never. Must be blood clot nice to not have to work. But just come into work to get paid to work. To just tell people how much you don't have to work. White privilege. And this not dear white people, this is facts only. This is facts only. This is stuff that I've actually witnessed on a day-to-day basis. This is some shit that you go through and you gotta tell a motherfucker like, bro, you can't make this up. Life sound like a whole movie. Life sounded like Queen and Slim out this hoe. Get the fuck out of here. 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 They had Trump out there popping all that hot shit. Now he wanna allow praying in school all of a sudden. Fuck you. And your orange ass. And your stupid ass wife too. Fuck all of y'all. Yeah, I said it. I'm on live. The fuck? What the fuck? What in the fuck? Y'all are serious. Y'all are serious. Y'all are serious. Y'all dead eyes. No. No. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Y'all could stand for that if y'all want to, but I'll kindly sit the fuck down. I'll kindly sit the fuck down for that. I'll kindly have several seats for that shit. You wanna... Oh, now we gotta go to war. Oh, now it might be a draft. Oh, they picking up the gays and the women and the trans and the everybody gotta muscle up. No, nigga, hit that whoa and sit your ass the fuck down, because I ain't going nowhere for this country. Nowhere. No, send me back. Ancestry.com the fuck out me. Send me back. Send me back where the fuck I came from. Because, bitch, you got me fucked up. You got me all the way fucked up. Like, like what? What? Who? Not I, said the cat. Not I, said the cat. Mm-mm. No. That's a whole dub. An entire dub. Not a W. Like an L. Loss. No. Whatever the lingo is for that shit, that's what the fuck it is. Cause I ain't doing that shit. That's dumb as hell. Y'all got it fucked up. George Bush ain't care about black people. None of y'all gave a fuck about the black people. We was the slaves, remember? Y'all didn't give a fuck about us. Bitch, I'm back out my coma. Like, what the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck? What the that's what y'all doing? That's what y'all wanna do out here? Let me know. Cause I'm gonna write it down for y'all. Because, no, take accountability for your actions. Take accountability for what you bring into this world. Period. I don't think a lot of people understand the strength and the power that is within their natal charts and stuff like that. And I don't care if y'all not really into, like, all right, so it's deeper than Zodiac. I'm start there. It's deeper than Zodiac. You really have to pay attention to who you are. Your natal chart literally tells you exactly how the stars were aligned, how the planets were in the universe at that time that you decided to take your first breath. Your natal chart is supposed to give you all of that information. So with that information, you now have the direct responsibility to understand you and the impact that you put on the world, on the universe. You came in on this day. The sun was in Gemini. The moon was in Leo. You know what I'm saying? Like, take it from the top. Learn the story. Get grounded. Get your roots going. Get the root chakra popping and all that shit that y'all think is a fucking trend when it's a fucking lifestyle. Literally, your lifestyle is in your natal chart and you don't want to look because you're too fucking scared of what you're going to find. But, stop me when I'm wrong. The fuck? Look into your shit. Look into who you are. You want to know you so much. You want to know how you need to be loved. You need to know how you love other people. You need to know... Y'all don't even know yourselves. And y'all want to know all these other people and all these other entities. And you want... house, car, marriage, this, that, the third. How are you going to attract that to you being who you are? Having that level of energy that you have in this moment. Because timing is fluid. So when you came on this earth, you came on this planet, all this other shit was going on anyway. With or without you. This shit bigger than you. This shit is bigger than you. It's not just you. All these fucking different mini universes walking on one fucking planet when there are so many that align at different times. Again, it goes right back to that shit. And you want to tell a motherfucker that they're not God? If you're made in God's image, again, we were made in God's image, not man's image. So to even call us man is disrespectful. Man or woman. No. God. God herself, God himself. Like, you. I and I. You get what I'm saying? Like, you have to get your shit right, bro. Like, you literally have to get your shit right. You need to start with you. You need to start with you. Period. Point blank, period. That's it. Because how do you expect to attract other people to you when you don't even know whether you give off honey or vinegar? You don't know if your shit stink or it don't. But you trying to figure out why motherfuckers don't come your way. Like, what the fuck? What the fuck? What the... I am a god. Now you mad at the man for telling you who the fuck he was already? I am a god. Point blank, period. We are kings and queens of the universe. Literally. Literally. Made in the image of God. Not made in the image of man. What the fuck is that? Man or woman? No. No. We're one. God. If you want to get fancy with it, goddess. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm God herself. Look at God in all her splendiferousness. And then y'all want to settle for people who think of themselves as less than that. Why? Why would you ever want to lower your vibration, lower your frequency? For what? For what? Oh, the dick good, huh? Pussy tighter than a U-turn with no power steering fluid, huh? Okay. All right, that's a good reason. That's a dope reason to want to be with somebody. Because it look good and it sound good and it sort of kind of feel good when you give me the henny dick or she drunk off the tequila or they high off that. No, 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 no. They don't know what vibrations mean. They don't know what good vibes only means. They don't know what positive vibes are. Like, y'all want to feel a vibe so bad and don't even know what vibes is short for. Do y'all know who Bob Marley is? No, y'all just use Marley papers. And then y'all talk shit about them. But Bob Marley, all he did was smoke. And he probably didn't even get to smoke his own papers. Because y'all just, like, took his name and his image and created your own papers to just be whack and stupid. And have a bad habit that a lot of you can't really afford. And then a lot of you decide to pick up selling it so that you can afford it, and then you end up like smoking up all your shit and giving it out to your friends and not really even making any money. Really? Oh my god, stupid. Like, y'all dumb as hell. Y'all dumb. These are facts only. If that's how you move, you're dumb. I don't even know if y'all can hear that beeping, but that's my phone telling me that my blood sugar is probably high. So I'm gonna need to take some insulin in a few, but I'm not done talking. So I'll drink some water and call it a happy day. But no, some real shit, like, know your rights. Read about who you are. Know about, it's deeper than you. It's deeper than Zodiac. It's deeper than what's right in front of you. It's deeper than yesterday. It's deeper than right now. It's deeper than 2 days from now. It's deeper than, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is a constant and consistent type of thing. Like, this is an ongoing journey. There's gonna be new shit that you're gonna learn about yourself tomorrow that you didn't think of, never even dwelled on for the entirety of your being. And we're adults. Most of the people that are on my Facebook right now, they're grown. Grown adult people. I don't really add too many young folk. I'm sorry. I just don't. They're weird. New social media is weird. And I don't want to be nobody. No. I'm not a cougar. Never been. I've been an old soul my whole life. So, like, I can't even. Like, I'm childish. I'm very childish. I'm very youthful. I like to, you know, I play all day. Okay. But I'm getting old. Dirt. I'm not old. I'm getting older. So, I can't be out here playing and having small talk ass conversations. Like, I can't stay in the box that is the American flag. Like, I literally just cannot. So, I'm good on that. But I feel like we need to be holding this nation accountable. And I feel like we need to be holding ourselves accountable as well. Because it's really not that hard to be better people. It's really not that hard to have a peaceful world. Mother Nature is vexed. She's angry. And I told y'all I was in my feelings. And I told y'all, all right, so I posted a couple days ago, Mother Nature is a Gemini. She is. She is. Take it from a Gemini. Take it from a Gemini. Mother Nature is a Gemini. She is. She is. She is. I'm an evolved Gemini, so a lot of people can vibe with me because I know myself and I know my effects on other people. I'm very self-aware. Got it tatted, you know. So I know what my vibes are and how I impact other people, so I'm able to kind of adapt. Not that I'm fake or two-faced, because a lot of people get that misconstrued, but I just know myself. And I'm a big energy reader, so I can read how I'm going to affect you before I even affect you. And I adjust so that I don't offend or whatever the case may be. I'm going to still probably piss you off and offend you or whatever, but so what? I don't give a fuck. I already told you that, though, so self-awareness is key. I'm not for everybody, and everybody ain't for me. But it'll be all right. Like, that's fine. I went off on a whole tangent and don't even remember. Oh, Mother Nature is a Gemini. Yeah, so Mother Nature is a Gemini. One day it's 60 degrees. Next day it's winter storms is coming. Next day it's raining, thundering, and lightning in the middle of January, middle of December. So that's not normal. That's not normal. I'm not saying that Geminis aren't normal, but what I'm saying is she's switching. She's being very moody. She's being very bipolar. Like, the weather don't stay the same for longer than a couple days at a time. So that's something that y'all need to pay attention to. We need to pay attention to shit like that. Our bodies are 70% water. Like, where the moon is in its orbit affects the water. It affects the tide. That's what high tide is and all that other stuff. Like, y'all really need to look into our connections with the universe, with the moon and the placement of the stars and the other planets and what that does to us on Earth. That's just all the energy that people bring into the universe. I hate it here. No, or some real shit. That's literally, like, that's what I'm saying. So if we focus on the fact that we're so fucked up to the point that we're fucking up Mother Nature, she naturally is supposed to move from spring to summer to fall to winter. Spring, summer, fall, winter. Like, she's supposed to do that and do it gradually and do it gracefully. Not just boom, 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 up, down, round, round. No, that's not how that works. There's routine. There's cycle. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a circle of life, the tree of life, all that stuff. Like, nature is a process. Things grow, then die, get used up to then grow. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you gotta keep that flow moving. So if Mother Nature... And then y'all got the fucking GMO, genetically modified, this, that, and the third.
Someone else is listening to your Pandora account right now.
Only why? Who? How? How the fuck? Who is this? Then got the nerve to have other people listening to my Pandora account. But I can't say that I own the getting on my nerves. But no, on some real, we do need to heal. We need to heal everyone.
Hello.
not fake heal like you said earlier. Literally take the time to know yourself. Like, no, it takes a while. It takes a while. It's not going to be easy. And I'm not on here telling y'all it's going to be easy to do. It's easy to be better people, yes, but you have to put yourself in the mindset. You have to put yourself in a place where you can receive that and for you to give that out, period. Like, this don't make sense. This is not okay. This is not how this is supposed to play out. Nobody's supposed to be living like this. Nobody. Nobody is supposed to be living like this at all. There's supposed to be things against monopolies. There's supposed to be things. Welfare is supposed to be helping people who can't necessarily help themselves. And that's getting abused by people of all shades. Not just shouting out black people. Not trying to put people that are on welfare down or nothing like that. But what I'm saying is those programs get abused. And the people who really need those programs can't get those programs because they're being abused. We need healthcare in order to be healthy, in order to go out and make a living wage, but we can't afford it because the job that gives us this living wage doesn't pay us enough to even be able to afford it. And even if they take it out of our paychecks ahead of time through the company that we're working for, the benefits still are trash, and medication is still expensive, and it's still hard to get appointments, and it's still hard to take days off to be able to get those appointments. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a constant cycle of not being able to come up. And that's not fair. That's not a working system. Who does that work for? I want to know. Who does this system work for? Because we're not a democracy. We're a republic. A white man told me that. Who probably voted for Trump and is really upset about it. I'm not really sure who he voted for. He didn't tell me. I'm glad he didn't. But I know I did this leg already, but my business. Let me rock. But nah, for real. You know why we brainwash. I'm not gonna go into that though. I'm biased. I feel we can all heal ourselves of everything. Nah, you're not biased. You're informed. Every illness, every mental illness, that's a fact. It's mind over matter. It's literally mind over matter. You can do it. You just have to want to do it. You have to manifest on those things. And people get so caught up in the timeline and the time frame, and I haven't done it yet, and I haven't seen it yet, and it's not there yet, and I'm not there yet, and it's not me yet, and it's not this yet, and they don't just start the process and get it done. What's impossible? What is? If you're a God, what's impossible? What can't you do? Cannot. Why not? It works for the elites who are making the big butts. Listen, not for long. It's a new year. 2020 is like, not saying that that's the name of the year, but that's literally like the name of the year, like 2020. Like, niggas is woke now. It took a while. It did take a while. I'm not going to stop. Niggas is woke. 2020 vision. We can see clearly now. You know what I'm saying? And with that vision and with that sight, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's time for us to really, like, take action. Because we've been sitting, literally, on this information for a really long time at this point. Like, we've been sitting on this information for quite some time, and it's not doing us any good. To know the information is great. To have the facts is great. That's a great start. It's a great start. Excellent start. Because you want to make sure that your ducks are in order. You want to make sure that you're not fighting a battle that you're going to lose. You know what I'm saying? Like, you have to know your opponent. Hi, America. Hi, KKK. Hi, everybody out there. iPhones, smartphones, Androids, whatever the fuck. They watching everybody. They don't care. They've never cared. They sit around and do stuff purposely to us and put the information right back in our faces and then hide certain shit, because again, they don't tell us everything the way they act like they do. They don't tell us everything. Scandal taught us that. Scandal taught us that. Scandal taught us that. Yes, we are currently in the Aquarius timeline, and this is why a lot of us are waking up. Nor will they ever care, because they are always wealthy. Not for long. Not for long. We coming for our coins, like I said. Like I said, we speaking affirmations going forward. Yeah. I was at work, and they got this running joke. Chelsea's a billionaire, so, you know, she could just quit. Chelsea's a billionaire, so she could just quit. Keep saying it. Law of attraction. I already done put it on my vision board. Run it up. Let's fuck up a check. Go ahead. Yes, Chelsea's a billionaire. Keep saying it. Yes, team. Yes, team. Speak that into existence. That's right. Chelsea's a billionaire. Because you say it like it's a joke. You say it like it's a joke, and I like that. Niggas love to play with me until I want to play back. Run that back, Turbo. Remember, Chelsea, a billionaire. She could just quit. Keep playing with me. Keep playing with me. Keep playing. Keep playing with me. I like that. Love it, even. Love it. Love it. I love funny. I love funny. 444. I don't even know if y'all can hear my music in the background. My shit on 10% though, so it's about to die anyway. My phone. So I'm gonna have to catch up with y'all another time. But run this video back or whatever. Play it for your friends. Share it. Whatever. I'm about to put it up on YouTube. Maybe tomorrow some shit. Like nigga, dog nigga, faux nigga, real nigga. Rich nigga, faux nigga, house nigga, feel nigga. Still nigga. The fuck? Still nigga. I like that second one. Nigga is a term of endearment for me, so I don't never feel no way. So I could still be nigga, I don't care. That's fine. They sure don't tell us everything, only what they want us to know. But like you said, we need to start with we need to start with self, and then we shall prevail. Okay. No, no, some real. That's facts. That's facts. We have to start with us. Because a lot of the issues is a lot of lost people are trying to lead people, and that's not going to work either. That's not going to work either. At all. That's not going to work. We really need as many people who are really passionate and really serious about the lifestyle, the movement. You have to know yourself. This is not a trend, and we're not going to be able to reach everybody. Everybody not going to be feeling that wave. Everybody's not going to understand it. Everybody's not going to want to vibrate that high. A lot of people are scared of heights. They don't like that, you know, steady cruising altitude up there with the high vibrations. They don't like that. They don't like that. They don't like it. It's weird. It's weird to them to speak about something that they've never heard of before, that they've tried to hide from us, that they didn't want us to get into, that they didn't want us to understand. You know, they gave us astrology, they gave us a zodiac, but they didn't want us to really get deep. It's always going to be hard. I mean, it's hard saving the world, but I'm not trying to save the whole world. Just the ones worth saving. Everybody's technically worth saving, but you have to know that. You have to know that you're worth saving to even understand the conversation to begin with. So that's a start for me. We got to do something. Good night, though, baby. Love you. But on some real shit, like, I don't, again, I'm not a small talk type of person. Like, I don't, if I'm gonna have to care about something, it has to be like all or nothing. It has to be like 0 to 100. It can't be this petty bullshit. Ugh. When there's so many other things to care about, y'all wanna care about petty bullshit? Ugh. Gross.
Still nigga.
I don't really know how I feel too much about Jay-Z. I don't know how, he is Sagittarius. I don't really know what's going on with his whole natal chart, but I know he is Sagittarius man, so. That's either hit or miss. Go to bed. I don't really know what time it is anyway. But, even if I did, probably still wouldn't be asleep. I'd probably be up. So if I'm gonna be up, I might as well be up doing something productive. And adding to my show is definitely productive because I haven't even done a show in a while. So appreciate your concern about my sleeping schedule though. I really do, because I do need to get some sleep. I got work in the morning. Whoo, Jesus. I gotta stop being an asshole. But I'm not. I might have to stop at some point. I don't think so. It makes me who I am. I take it back. Change my mind. I could be an asshole if I want to. It's what makes me who I am. But yeah. The video really started with me being outraged about the little girl getting beat up on the bus. Kids are not supposed to be going out there and being worried about other kids assaulting them at 5 years old. That's just not okay. And again, I don't have kids, but I just know it wouldn't have been my baby. It just wouldn't have. It just couldn't have been. It couldn't have been. Mm-mm. Everybody would have to pay. Everybody would have to pay. They have to go. Everybody would have to go. And then for you to have to pay $600 to get the videotape back. Or not the videotape, but at least to get a copy of it. That's disgusting. That's not okay. That's not dope. That's not okay. You trusted your child to this bus driver, to this school district, to this bus company to take that child to and from school, and they're being assaulted by somebody's raggedy ass kids. That don't make no sense. That's not okay. And whether you're a parent or not, if you're okay with some shit like that going down, no matter what, no. Because it's not even about, like, black kids versus white kids or nothing like that. Because a lot of people think because I'm pro-black that I hate white people. And that's not necessarily the case. I don't hate white people. I don't hate white people at all. I love all people. That's just in my nature. I don't hate anybody. But ignorant white people, racist white people, I don't really care for them too much. They make what it is that we need to do a lot harder. Entitled white people, old money right white people. Yeah. I don't like it. Because there's some really cool white people out there. Shout out to all my cool white people. Shout out to the white people who are not fucking stupid. I appreciate them. I appreciate the fuck out of them. The white people who are grounded and know what the fuck is up, I fuck with them on a whole different type of level. I really do. Because that's hard to be white and be woke. People hate you. White people hate you. Black people hate you. That's real shit. They might as well be mixed. They might as well be mixed. They might as well have a little drop of the black blood in them. Because, I mean, how... That's another show. 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 It's getting late. It's getting late. But, yeah, y'all. I'm just... I had some stuff I had to get off my chest, so that's what I was doing. So, I'm gonna just, you know, go. Because I've been on here for almost an hour now. So again, run the video back. I appreciate y'all. I'm gonna start doing this a lot more often. You know, just work with me. Like I said, I'm gonna do my videos when I want to anyway, but I want to do them more often. So you'll see me more often. We're gonna keep talking about what we need to talk about. Thank you. I appreciate that. I mean, I'm kind of yellow because the light kind of bright, but I appreciate that. Yeah, so next time I'll be back. We're going to talk about some real shit. And if y'all have any, like, suggestions about, like, topics or shows that y'all want to see or whatever the case, or things that y'all want to talk about, y'all could always hit me up. I've always said that. It's kind of like a free-for-all, free-form type of shit. Where I just want to talk about what's going on around us, because we can't avoid that. Safe place is a safe haven for you to talk about whatever it is you need to talk about, get it off your chest or whatever. And then at some point we definitely gotta do something about that shit, you know? So I'll see y'all. Y'all see me later, y'all.